Hi everyone, Michelle Fixit here. Today we're going to be caulking windows before they get painted. This whole room needs to be painted. So before you paint the trim and the window around the windows and everything like that, you should give them a thorough cleaning. You should also take this as an opportunity to clean out your window tracks and stuff like that. If your windows are having issues going up and down and they're getting stuck or there's any dirt or grime in there, you should clean that out as well so that way you're not doing that on fresh paint. So without further ado, we're going to start caulking these windows. So you need a caulk gun with caulk in it. I have Alex Painter's acrylic latex caulk. Comes with a 25-year warranty. It's paintable. It's the cheapest thing that Home Depot has. It works pretty well, gets the job done. And I'm not just gonna throw some paint on windows. I'm gonna caulk them beforehand because otherwise they're gonna look bad. You also wanna have paper towels, or what would be preferred is baby wipes, a bowl with some water in it. You can use gloves if you would like. Otherwise, just use your finger. It's not a big deal. Without further ado, let's get it started. So we are gonna have to work around these little window alarms. But if you look at the base of the window down here, you'll see that it's just in really bad shape. It has been previously cleaned. And it would be really good if you had an old paintbrush as well, because even though you cleaned your windows or your window sills and window casing, it's still really good to give them a good brush out with an old paintbrush just to make sure there's nothing in there, because this window does have stuff in it. If you have any old tape or hardware, oh wow, you also want to take that out or off. Because once you paint it, it's going to be there forever. So you just want to get everything good dusting. I am going to end up taking these out. So I'm doing this video for you guys' benefit. So I'm going to have to work up to them and drag down. But these, if you have anything like that, take it out as well. And if you feel like you can skip caulking, don't do it. It makes your whole paint job look really crappy. All right, so dusted out this window. Let's start back down here. So you just get your caulk gun and you make as even of a strip as you can. I like starting in one area first, and then I'm going to drag the excess. So I'm gonna use my finger, drag along. And then any of this excess, I'm going to be putting on any areas that are going to need it. Oh, you guys can't even see. Oh, well, yeah, you can see. There we go. So, here we go. I'm going to just drag it because this all looks just atrocious. And this window's been previously caulked by someone that is not me, so it looks really bad. When you have a corner like this, you just drag up and you're smushing it in there, best of your abilities. And from this vantage, I'm actually seeing that all down here looks really bad too. So I use my finger to smear as much of it as I can, because once I get done, I'm going to end up using baby wipes, or in my case, because I don't have baby wipes available to me, a wet paper towel, or shall I say, a damp paper towel. So just smear, get all the excess off that you can, put it in a different area where it needs it. Oh wow, around the whole, this also needs to be caulked. Because if you skip this stuff and you just paint it, it doesn't look so bad. That's why people talk about the landlord special stuff. Like, just common sense stuff. Like, if you wouldn't want it at your house, don't do it at somebody else's house. I can't help the fact that there's all these little weird areas. Because that's pre-existing damage to this, from somebody else's hard, not hard work. And again, I will be taking these out and those little guys out. Drag it down. I like to do one area or one thing at a time and then break out the paper towels and everything. one side, I smear it, clear it. Go on the other side, smear it, clear it. It's really hard doing it after somebody else because they have all these yucky spaces. All right, oh, you guys are still up there. I'll do this up really quick too. Here. This is just the excess. I'm just rubbing it in. Just things move and shift and all that stuff. Just keep dragging it down. If you have excess on the sides, take it off. Alright, and then I've got barely any excess. So I'm gonna have to do another stream here. Ooh, way more than I wanted. Oh, but you know what? I've got this area I can't reach. So I'm gonna have to come in here with water for another one. Look around your casing, your window casing, and if you have, or your window trim, if you have areas that need to get filled, just do it. It just looks better. It looks so much better. It's not faster, but it looks better. But sometimes you can get away with not even having any wipe downs and stuff. Like this area is just going to get wiped down just because I want to make sure it looks perfect. But, well, as perfect as it can get for the crappiness that other people did to it. Again, now that I have excess, I'm spreading the excess in other areas. Window casing is ready for a wipe down. Like under here is it looks bad. And no one's gonna see that but me, or if somebody's right down here on the floor, but I will know it's here, so I am going to fix it. Right, that all looks really good. Minus the fact that somebody yucked it up another time. Right, we're gonna get our Terra Square. It's a new kind of paper towel that I wasn't aware of, and I think it's cute. And then I fold it up into a little square. dip it in a smidgen of water, just a smidge, like half of it, and then I squeeze out the excess. I'm just gonna rub everything down. And that way I know that it's seamless. We don't have all those nasty caulk lines that are here everywhere because somebody else decided to throw a caulk on it and not smooth it out. And the best way to do this is to wrap it around your finger, like so. And that way it just looks really good. That's all it takes.
So now I'm just gonna do the other ones and you guys can watch.
All once you have enough excess, then you just move to another area so you don't mess up other areas. So always look for your big gaping holes first, and then just reserve it for the bad areas. Yes, there are a couple little nicks on the frame, so covering those up. So otherwise, they're going to look bad too. Thank you.
these little guys out. I can't do anything up there. I need baby wipes over here. I need to do it with a baby towel. Thank you.
Gotta feel the vibration. There we go.
Now my hands are all yucky.
He just rinsed some with water.
You guys can't see, but that's what I'm doing.
You guys have a great day. All right, we'll see you next project.
Bye! Like and subscribe.